हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस 11th वीडियो ऑन कॉम्प्लेक्स एनालिसिस। टिल नाउ व्हाट वी नो व्हाट इज द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड, व्हाट इज द कॉम्प्लेक्स प्लेन सी, ओके, एंड वी नो अलजेब्रा ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स, दैट इज वी नो हाउ टू ऐड टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स, हाउ टू सब्ट्रैक्ट, हाउ टू डिवाइड एंड सो ऑन। सो नेक्स्ट कम्स द फंक्शंस फ्रॉम अ कॉम्प्लेक्स प्लेन टू कॉम्प्लेक्स प्लेन, राइट? सो वी विल स्टडी द कॉम्प्लेक्स वैल्यूड फंक्शंस ऑफ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स वेरिएबल, दैट इज आर नेक्स्ट टास्क, राइट? अर्लियर व्हाट वी नो, वी हैड समथिंग लाइक दिस, वी हैड दिस रियल लाइन एंड दिस इज आर रियल लाइन, वी हैड फंक्शंस फ्रॉम आर टू आर, ओके, वी ऑलरेडी नो हाउ दीज फंक्शंस आर, ओके, एंड वी ऑल्सो नो दैट हाउ टू डिफ्रेंशिएट एंड इंटीग्रेट सच फंक्शंस. Functions from R to R, we know how to differentiate these functions, how to integrate these functions, and that thing comes under the subject of real analysis, right? Now we would like to generalize this thing from generalize this thing from real to complex. So basically, what we want to look at the functions from set of complex numbers to set of complex numbers. These are the functions which we would like to know, that how these functions look and what are their properties and so on. And then we would like to know how can we differentiate and integrate these functions. How to differentiate and integrate these functions. That is our next task. And this subject is known as complex analysis. Okay. So first of all, we'll start with the definition of function. And then we will see how a function from complex plane to complex function plane is defined. Okay. So let us look at that. Okay, so we will start with the definition of complex function, or we will start with the definition of function only, right? So simple definition of function, what is the simple definition of function? A function basically is a mapping from a set A to a set B, right? So basically you have two sets, set A and set B, right? A function f is a mapping from a set A to set B, right? This is your set A, this is your set B, and this is a mapping from set A to set B which satisfies certain properties. What are those properties? That properties are, first thing is that no element of A should be unassigned, that every element of A should be assigned to some element of B, and every element should be assigned to one and only one element of B. Okay, so basically the definition of a function is a rule, okay, which assigns one and only one element to every element of set A, okay, one and only one element of set B, right? For example, consider this case. Here we have three elements in the set A and we have four elements in the set B. In the first case, all the elements of A are associated and one element is assigned to one and only one element of B, okay? Here this element of B is left unassociated, but that is not a problem, right? All we need is that no element of A should be unassociated. So this is a function. This comes in the category of function. Here every element of A is associated, that is no element of A is left unassociated, and two elements of A are assigned the same value, okay? But that is not a problem. All we want is that no single element should be assigned two different values in B, right? So this is also a function. Here, see, in the third case, one element of A is left unassociated, therefore it is not a function. And here, one element of A is assigned two different elements of B, so it is not a function, right? So function is a rule from set A to B such that no element of A is left unassigned and no element of A is assigned two different values in B, right? Here, the set A is, earlier when we were talking of functions from R to R, okay, this set A and set B were the subsets of R, okay? Earlier, the set A and set B were subsets of R, and now we are talking of functions from C to C, right? So both A and B are subsets of C, okay? And here, this set A is called domain of definition of the function f, okay? In the earlier videos, we have seen that a domain is a region in the C plane which is open and connected, right? But this domain of definition has nothing to do with this domain. This domain is different thing. This domain open connected region is called domain, which we have seen in the earlier videos. This domain of definition and this domain, these are two different things. You don't have to confuse these two things. Okay, so this is domain of definition. So if you have a function from A to B, right? So we will call the set A as the domain of definition of F. Suppose this is function F, domain of definition of F, right? Okay, let us move on. Okay, and if F assigns a value B to an element A of the set A, then we write it as this. B is equal to F of A, right? And we know that all the elements of B may not be associated to elements of A. So the set, the subset of B, okay, which is the image, which is the set of images of all the elements of A under F. Okay, so basically the subset of B, which is F of A, where A belongs to A, okay, that will be a subset of B. This is called range of F, right? Now we have two things. We have a function F from a set A to set B, right? This set is called domain of definition of F, and the part which is used here in B is called range, okay, and this is called domain of definition of F, okay. And you have to keep in mind that this domain of definition is a different thing than the domain which we have talked about earlier. So this domain was an open connected subset of C, right? This domain may not be open connected set, right? For example, if you are given this function z square minus 1 upon z square plus 1, so basically this is a function from C to C, right? Then what is the domain of this function? This function is defined everywhere except when this z square plus 1 is equal to 0. That is, except when we want that z square plus 1 should not be equal to 0. That is, we want z square should not equal to 1. That is, z should not be equal to plus minus iota. So domain of this function is all complex numbers except plus minus iota. And range of this function is, this function can assume any complex number, therefore range is C. So this particular function, for this particular function, domain of definition is C minus plus minus iota. So basically it is defined for all C except this plus iota and minus iota. This is the domain of the function, right? Domain of definition of the function except these two points, and the range is whole of the complex plane. Okay, this was about domain and range of the functions of complex variables, complex valued functions of complex variables. So basically we are talking of functions from C to C. We can also talk of functions from C to R, right? That is real valued function of complex variable. But that is, this particular case is a specific, like this case is a particular case of this particular case, right? So therefore we will study the functions from C to C. We will call those functions as complex valued functions of complex variables, right? And this is real valued functions of complex variable. Okay, thank you.